Welcome to the second part of my lecture, that is one factor experiments. So there are three basic experimental designs for allotting different treatments, or you can say these are the levels of single factors to the experimental unit. Depending upon the experimental material you are using and experimental area, there are three basic designs which we are using in our field experiment. These are completely randomized design, randomized block design, and Leighton square design. So we will discuss in brief what are these designs, under what situation they are used. So first one is your completely randomized design, popularly known as CRD. It is the simplest design among all the designs due to its analysis and ease of its layout. The total experimental area in this design is divided into the number of units or experimental plots, and treatments are allotted at random or by chance. So you completely apply the treatment in a random fashion to each of the experimental plot. The CRD is used when we have homogeneous experimental material. If we take some example, suppose in agricultural field experiment, when all the plot have same soil fertility, soil texture, and uniform agronomical practices. If we are conducting the experiment in animal science, where animals are of same breed, grown in similar conditions, then CRD will be used. Generally, CRD is used in laboratory techniques or methodological studies, greenhouse experiments. There are so many advantages, or you can say there are so many reasons to use a CRD, because it has very easy layout, its analysis is the simplest one, it has the flexibility with respect to the number of treatment. You can take any number of treatment, any number of replication, and it allows us for the maximum degrees of freedom in error, so that our precision can be increased. In completely randomized design, missing data can be handled very easily. It is suited only for small number of treatments, because when we are using large number of treatments which need more experimental area, and as the experimental area increases, it is very difficult for an experimenter to maintain the homogeneity in such experimental area. So it is a very simple layout. I am just giving the layout of a CRD by considering an examples. The whole experimental area, as I have already said, is divided into a number of units, for example, say capital N, and this N is sum of all the replications for each treatment. And all the treatments are allocated randomly to all the units. If we assign, suppose we have three treatments, they are randomly assigned to N, capital N units, such that your first treatment, that is TI, is allotted to RI unit. In other words, we want to say, suppose we have five treatments, T1, T2, T3, T4, and T1 is replicated four times, T2 three times, T3 four times, T4 again four times, and T5 say five times. Then, first of all, we will find out how many experimental units we should use or we are needed. So we will sum up all the replications of this treatment. It comes out to be 20. So experimental area is divided into these 20 plots. These are the plots, 20 plots. And now we will use random numbers in order to assign these treatments to these 20 experimental area. So the of course this design has a model and a simple additive model we are using in this design. Suppose yij is the jth unit in ih treatment, then that observation can be modeled by using this model mu, which is journal effect, ti is the treatment effect, and eij is the error associated with the observation yij. And it is assumed that this error is normally distributed with zero mean and constant variance sigma squares. So the layout you will obtain is, say, y11 is the your first observation, means it is the observation recorded on, you can say, first treatment receiving first replication, in first replication, first treatment, second replication, first treatment, rth replication, r1th replication, and this is the a layout. Then what we do is we will take the sum of all the observation who are receiving first treatment, t2 is the sum of all the observation receiving second treatment. Likewise, you can take the sum and you can take the mean also by dividing first sum with r1, second sum with r2, and so on and so forth. So then we will find out the grand total n, number of experimental unit n as sum of all the ris, and grand total g, which is sum of all the treatment totals, or you can say sum of all the observations. After computing this, correction factor can be computed by g square by n, sum of square. We will square each terms of the table and then sum it up, and this correction factor is subtracted from this. The total sum of square can be obtained. Similarly, treatment sum of square can be obtained by just squaring the treatment sums and divide it by the respective number of replications and sum up and subtract the CF. And error sum of squares can be obtained by subtraction. So all the sum of squares are there, then we can prepare analysis of variance table in which we have source of variation is treatment, error, and total. Since we have T treatments, and we will get T minus 1 degrees of freedom, and total experimental units are capital N, so N minus 1 is the total degree of freedom. If I subtract the treatment degree of freedom from the total degree of freedom, I will get error degrees of freedom. So this is sum of squares, and when sum of squares are divided by respective degrees of freedom, then we will get MSS. So suppose T representing the MSS of treatment and E representing the MSS of error. So I divide this T by E, we will get F calculated. In testing of hypothesis, if f calculated value is greater than f tabulated at, say, t minus 1 degrees of degree of freedom at numerator and n minus t degrees of freedom at denominator, we can say that treatments are significant. In order to find out which treatment are significant, we will use the SC of mean by E divided by RI, and SED or difference of means is given by E divided by 1 by RI plus 1 by RJ, where RI and RJ are the replication of TI and TJ. If we have RI is equal to RJ, means all the replications are equal, suppose say R, then SED can be calculated by 2 EMS upon R. And after computing the SAD, we will find out the critical difference. Just multiplying this SAD with T at error degrees of freedom at specified level of significance. So we go for CD only when we got our F calculated, found to be significant. And in order to compare two treatments, I and J, we will take the absolute difference of these two treatments and compare it with CD. And we can say that if your absolute difference is greater than CD, then TI and TJ, they differ significantly. So this is a very simple example. Then second type of design we are using in one factor experiment is randomized complete design. Where it is used, what is the layout, I just give a brief introduction of this randomized complete block design. If you have an experimental area which is not homogeneous and your fertility gradient is in one direction only, then it is possible to divide the whole area into homogeneous blocks or groups which are perpendicular to the direction of the fertility gradient. In this way, we are dividing the total fertility into various groups equally. Then the treatments are randomly allocated separately to each block, and the result you will get, the resulting design you will get, is your randomized block design. So layout is very simple. The plot within block must be homogeneous as far as possible. Thus, the of the direction called fertility gradient, in which fertility changes are maximum, is known to us. So we will proceed like this. Suppose we have the fertility gradient in this direction, x to y. Then we will make blocks perpendicular to this direction, this direction, this direction. Now these plots are homogeneous within itself and they are heterogeneous between themselves. So we will take each block B1 and then we will assign all the treatment at random to this block. The similar arrangement of treatment or similar procedure is used for second block separately, third block separately, fourth block separately, and fifth block separately. So this is the layout of the design and under what situation this design is used and why it is used. First one is the sensitivity, or you can say its sensitiveness. The design removes one direction or one way of heterogeneity, the variation between the blocks from that within blocks, which results in decrease in experimental error. As experimental error decreases, means your precision will be increased. Second reason to use the randomized block design is its flexibility. This design allows any number of treatments and any number of replications, with the restrictions that the number of replication is proportional to the number of blocks. But sometime if extra replication is desired for an experimenter for some treatments, they may be applied to two or more units within each block. So if we have V number of treatments, then maximum number of replication, which ensure that you should get at least 12 error degrees of freedom, is given by this formula, R is equal to 1 plus 12 by V minus 1. Another reason of using the randomized block design is ease of analysis. The statistical analysis remain very simple even if some of the observations are missing. So you can use this design because you can perform the unbiased comparisons. Of course, there are certain demerits also. It cannot control the variation in the experimental material from two sources. If the variations are coming from two sources, if your fertility gradient is not in a single direction, if it is in both the directions, then this design cannot be used. If you have large number of treatment, then the size of the block will increase. And when the size of the block is increases, then it is not possible for an experimenter to maintain the homogeneity within that block. Due to which, when you have large number of treatment, then this design is not advisable. Its analysis, of course, in which one source of variability is also controlled by this design, so its model becomes Yij is equal to mu, which is general effect, Ti is the treatment effect, plus Vj is the block effect, jth block effect, and Eij as usual is the error term associated with the observation Yij. This error term is again assumed to be independently and normally distributed with zero mean and a constant variance sigma square E. Suppose we have say T treatments, the ith treatment being replicated R times, because in this design the number of replications are equal for each treatment and the replications must be equal to the number of blocks. So let capital Ti representing the sum of ith treatment, Rj representing the sum of your total of rth replications, like this. If you arrange your data as given in this table, then this T1, T2, T, they are representing the total of first, second and tth treatment. Similarly, R1, R2, R, they are representing the total of say first, second and rth replication. This Gt is the grand total. Then as usual, fraction factor can be obtained by just squaring this grand total and divide it by R into T. And total sum of square can be obtained by squaring each observation and adding and subtracting the correction factor. Similarly, other sum of squares due to treatment can be obtained by taking the square of each total, divide it by R and take their sum and subtract the correction factor. Similarly, we can find out the SS due to replications by just squaring R1 square plus R2 square plus RR square and divide it by number of treatments, say T, and subtracting this correction factor. So, and error can be obtained as usual by subtraction. So, we can construct the analysis of variance table as we have source of variation blocks, treatment, error and total. Since we have R block, so R minus 1 degrees of freedom for blocks is there, T minus 1 degrees of freedom for treatment is there, and total we have RT units, so RT minus 1 degrees of freedom is for total. And sum of square as usual can be computed as given by various formula in previous slide. So suppose this is represented by S1, S2 and S3, and S is the total. We can find out mean sum of squares by dividing this S1 with R minus 1, S2 with T minus 1, you will get MS2 and MS3, error sum of square, can be obtained by dividing S3 by the error degrees of freedom. Of course, we can compute the F values, or you can say the blocks are compared with error and treatments are also compared with error. So MS1 is divided by MS3 will give a F value for blocks. Similarly, MS2 when divided by MS3 will give F value for treatment. So, conclusions. So, first of all, we will test the hypothesis by considering your null hypothesis that T1 is equal to T2, means there is no treatment significant difference between treatment is there against the alternate that treatment means are not equal. So what we do is we will compute our F. This F calculated for treatment comes out to be significant at say alpha level of significance. We compare the treatment means with critical difference, and for computing critical difference, first of all we will find out standard error of mean by formula MS3 divided by R, and standard error of difference of mean by formula 2 MS3, 2 EMS, or you can say expected mean sum of squares divided by R. Then the SED is multiplied by T at error degrees of freedom and a specified level of significance, you can find out CD. So in order to compare any two treatment means, so what we do is we will take the absolute difference of any two treatment means, and if that difference is greater than your CD value, we declare that pair differ significantly. Third design in this category is Latin square design. So this in RBD we were able to control one-way heterogeneity in our experimental materials. Sometimes we have two direction of heterogeneity, or we have to remove the heterogeneity either in two direction, or their direction is not known, or direction is diagonal. In that case, your RBD is not suitable, or CRD is not suitable. We will use the Latin square design. So in this design, the number of plots is the square of the number of treatment. For example, if V treatment is there, then we need V square plots. And these design are normally used in experiment to remove the heterogeneity of experimental material in two direction, as I have already said. Examples are there when the fertility variation is in two perpendicular direction, or the direction is not known to us, or there is a diagonal trend of fertility. If we are conducting the animal science experiment, when there is or there are two sources of variation which need two-way blocking in order to remove to make them homogeneous, or to remove that heterogeneity, if we taking the example of say milk yield, the breed and the lactation number are two sources of variation. Likewise, in experiment on increase in weights of pigs, the initial weights and breed of the pigs are two sources of variation. Then what are the layout, or what layout you should use in say Latin square design? So as I have already said, for comparing V treatment you need V square experimental plot, and they are divided, these V square units are divided into V rows and V columns. So you can say make a square type arrangement, and treatment are allotted in such a way that each treatment occurs exactly once in each row and each column. Such type of arrangement is called Latin square. The term V, or that is the number of treatment, is called order of the Latin square. There is two-way blocking, one as row block and other is column block, such that each row as well as each column is a complete replicate. Means either you consider row as a block, then you will find all the treatment will be available in that row. If you are considering column as a say block, then in that column also all the treatments are there. So example, to randomize a Latin square, we start a basic Latin square, such as arrangements are, and these arrangements are the arrangements of treatments are readily available in various tables for statistician and biometrician, given by Fisher and Yates, and for a order. So you will get the order of Leighton square from 4 to, you can say, 12 or 15 is readily available. So here is an example. I am giving a Leighton square of order 5. That is, you can use this Leighton square in order to compare the 5 treatment, and your experimental plot is has you can say heterogeneity in two direction. So advantages: with two-way grouping, this design can control more of the variation than CRD and RVD. In CRD, we are assuming that the experimental material is homogeneous, whereas in RVD, one-way heterogeneity can be removed. So using this design, we can remove, we can eliminate rather the two-way heterogeneity, and due to which we will get small error mean sum of squares. It means you can increase the precision. Of course, analysis is very simple. Analysis remains very simple even when some of the observations are missing. The analytical procedures are available for omitting one or more treatment, one row or one columns. Leighton square design has wide variety of application in industry, laboratory, field, greenhouse, education, medical, marketing, and sociological experiment. Disadvantage is there when the number of treatments are large, means the Leighton square of order 4 to 12 is readily available, and if your Leighton, we want to compare more than 12 treatments and our layout is a Leighton square, then this need, and it is also not possible for an experimenter to maintain or to design such experiment. Repeated Leighton square of size 2 into 2 or 3 into 3 are found useful in certain situation to keep the error degrees of freedom reasonably adequate. So analysis, this is the model. Here we introduce the row and the column blocking. Ri is the row and Cj is the column block, and Tk is the treatment, you can say Yijk is the observation recorded on which received ith row. This is not ith, it is ith row, jth column and kth treatment. Mu is the your journal effect, Ri is the ith row effect, Cj is the jth column effect, and Tk is the kth treatment effect. And again, this Eij is the error, random error associated with the observation Yijk, and it is normally distributed with zero mean and a constant variance sigma square. So what we do is we will compute the ith row total, we will compute jth column total, we will compute kth treatment total, and we will compute the grant total in order to get your data analysis. After computing this, the various sum of squares can be presented here in this analysis of variance table. So source of variation, we have the source of variation due to rows, due to columns, and due to treatment and error. So sum of squares, these are the formula by which you can compare compute the sum of squares. Mean sum of square can be obtained by dividing the respective sum of squares with their degrees of freedom, and then these rows, column and treatments mean squares are compared with error mean squares in order to get F values. If your F found to be significant, then we are able to find out the CD by computing the SED, standard error of difference of means, by this formula 2 EMS upon V. And if this value is multiplied by t-tabulated value at alpha level of significance and v minus 1 into v minus 2 degrees of freedom, we can get CD values, and this CD value is used to compare the means of various treatments. So thank you very much.